cry to the blood. I lift the cry to the blood. Oh, Jesus, it gets to revive all in my soul. Send down the rain, send down the rain, send down the gospel rain. Send down the rain, send down the rain, send down, down by the riverside, down by the riverside, down by the riverside. I'm gonna lay down my burden. All the troubles and trials, when I get home on the other side, I'm gonna shake my hands with the elders, tell all the people good morning. I'm gonna sit down beside my Jesus. I'm gonna sit down and rest a little while. It's soon be done. Trials, when I get home on the other side, I'm gonna shake my hands with the elders, tell all the people good morning. I wanna sit down beside my Jesus, sit down and rest a little while. I am on the rock, a rock is higher than I. We're going up together.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
God is good.
And all the time,
God is good.
That's his nature.
Please be seated. As we quiet our hearts and our minds to receive the blessing that will be shared with us during this Eucharistic celebration, we bear to mind that today is a great feast, the Feast of Pentecost. It is the feast of God's Spirit. The power of evil spirits have come to an end. We know how the evil spirit envy and poison our hearts. We know that evil spirits have anger and greed. The spirit of hatred destroys happiness and peace, the peace we have within. We are afraid of these spirits. Today, however, we praise the great deeds of God. He breathes up over us the spirit of power that he breathes on the apostle. His breath is like a storm and fire. Today, evil spirits become afraid. Their power is broken. We come together today to open ourselves to God, to allow him to breathe on us, like he did the first Christians in Jerusalem. Therefore, prepare ourselves for the coming of the Spirit. Is there within us a spirit of joy and gratitude? Is there within us a spirit of love and unity? Is there within us a spirit of going out to other people, joyfully telling them about Christ? When last did we talk about Christ to our children, in our neighborhoods, in our churches, who comes beside us in the buses? When last did you strike a conversation about Christ and about the Holy Spirit? Our readings this morning is taken from the St. Joseph Missal, page 1223, the New St. Joseph Missal, page 955, the New Missal, page 777, and from the Old Missal, page 270.
The Holy Ghost power is moving just like a magnet. The Holy Ghost power is moving just like a magnet. It's moving here, moving there, just like the day Pentecost. The Holy Ghost power is moving just like a magnet. The Holy Ghost power is The Holy Ghost power is moving all through the nations. It wins people here, people there, saving them from sin and fear. The Holy Ghost power moving all through the nations. The Holy Ghost power is moving in our community. The Holy Ghost power is moving in our community. Directing here, directing there, into the way, the truth, the life. The Holy Ghost power moving in our community. The Holy Ghost power is moving here in our worship. The Holy Ghost power is moving here in our worship. Prompting there to give our lives to Jesus Christ. The Holy Ghost power is moving here in our worship. The Holy Ghost power is moving just like a magnet. The Holy Ghost power is moving just like a magnet. Moving. Moving there just like the day of Pentecost. The Holy Ghost power is moving just like a magnet. The Holy Ghost power is moving all through the nations. The Holy Ghost power is moving all through the nations. It wins people here, people there, saving them from sin and fear. The Holy Ghost power is moving all through the nations. The Holy Ghost power is moving in our community. The Holy Ghost power is moving in our community. Directing here, directing there, into the way, the truth, the life. Holy Ghost power is moving in our community. The Holy Ghost power is moving here in our worship. Moving, moving, Holy Ghost power moving here in our worship. Here, prompting there to give our lives to Jesus Christ. The Holy Ghost power is moving here in our worship. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Blessed Holy Ghost, we welcome you. Come with power and fill our temple. Holy Ghost, we welcome you. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Blessed Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost power is moving just like a magnet. The Holy Ghost power is moving just like a magnet. Moving here, moving there, just like the day of Pentecost. The Holy Ghost power is moving just like a magnet.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, my brother.
the highest, and peace to his people on earth.
Peace be
to Jesus Christ, peace be open. You alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Lord. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Amen.
Okay, thank you. All right. Lecture du livre des Actes des Apôtres. Lorsque le jour de la Pentecôte fut accompli, ils étaient non ensemble au même endroit. Soudain, il y eut du bruit de cils, comme un vent volant. Et il remplit toutes les maisons où ils Ils verront apparaître des langues comme des femmes, si les hindes diversion. Se poseront au chacun d'eux, ils feront eux remplis du Saint-Esprit et commenceront à parler dans d'autres langues. À mesure que l'Esprit le permettant de les manifester. Les Juifs du vent, tous les peuples, sur les cuisines résidentes à Jérusalem à cette époque. En étendant ces bruits à fumant des contrées, cherchant les empereurs dans leur propre langue. Ils furent tous étonnés et me révélaient en distance. Tous ceux qui parlent ne sont pas de la Galiléenne. Alors comment se fait il que quelqu'un de l'Ouest ne plaintait parler de la langue maternelle? Parmi nous se trouvant de parler de Médée, des Élamites et des habitants de la Mésopotamie, de la Judée à la Cappadoce. Du pont était l'Asie, de la Phrygie, de la Pamphylie, de l'Égypte, de la région de Libye, border Messarine. Il y a des citoyens romains entendus, juifs de proselyté. Il y a aussi des chrétiens de l'Arabie. Et chacun de la news et la brune parlait de la grandeur, les yeux dans notre propre langue. Parole de Dieu.
The word of the Lord.
Your response is, Lord, send forth your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send forth your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send forth your spirit.
Lectura de la primera carta del apóstol San Pablo a los Corintios. Hermanos, nadie puede decir Jesús es Señor, sino por el Espíritu Santo. Y hay diversidad de carismas, pero un mismo Espíritu. Hay diversidad de ministerios, pero un mismo Señor. Y hay diversidad de actuaciones, pero un mismo Dios, que obra todo en todos. Pero a cada cual se la otorga la manifestación del Espíritu para el bien común. Pues lo mismo que el cuerpo es uno, y tiene muchos miembros, y todos los miembros del cuerpo, a pesar de ser muchos, son un solo cuerpo, así es también Cristo. Pues todos nosotros, judíos y griegos, esclavos
Jelo hom takatifu tuanga zeto kabigu rose tu kwamwanga ewe mungu rojo uje baba wa maskini uje mtoa wa vipaji uje mwanga wa mioyo ewe mungu rojo e mfariji mwema sana e rafiki mwanana e raha mustarehe ewe mungu rojo e mwanga mwenye heri wajaze waamini neema yako mioyoni ewe Mungu rojo bila nguvu yako wewe mwanadamu hana kitu kwake yote anakosa ewe nakuponya majeraha ewe Mungu rojo ulengeze ukaidi pasha moto baridi nyosha upotevu wetu
day of Pentecost, fire fall on me.
on the day of Pentecost, fire fall on me.
Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O
On the evening of the first day of the week, when the doors were locked, where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked, where the disciples were for the fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven, and whose sins you retain are retained." The Gospel of the Lord.
today concludes the Easter season, 50 days that from Jesus' resurrection to Pentecost. They are marked in particular way by the presence of the Holy Spirit. And the Spirit is in fact the Easter gift par excellence. He is the Creator Spirit who constantly brings about new things. Today, we come to the end of our Easter season. And so at this time, I symbolically put out the Paschal candle that we'll see from now on only at funerals and other such events. My dear friends, there is still a fire burning. And that fire is very hot because today is Pentecost. So choir, be gonna stand up for me now, please. And I never like how that fire, this thing too short. Cause a day was supposed like this, you're supposed to catch it a fire, no so. I wish somebody soul order. Say what? Me not hear you.
Burn them with the Holy Ghost. I wish somebody told would I catch a fire. Burn them, Jesus. Burn them with the Holy Ghost. Oh, I wish somebody told would I catch a fire. Catch a fire. Catch a fire, Jesus. I wish somebody told would I catch a fire. Burn them with the Holy Ghost. By the river someday. Oh, meet me by the river someday. Meet me by the river, not far away. Oh, when my Lord shall call me home, happy, happy home beyond the sky. Meet me by the river.
I can't stay no longer with you. For my pleasures of sin, I can't stay no longer with you. I made up my mind to go that way the rest of my life. I made up my mind to go that way the rest of my life. Goodbye world, I can't stay no longer with you. Goodbye pleasures of sin, I can't stay no longer with you. I made up my mind to go that way the rest of my life.
I made up my mind to go that way the rest of my life.
Pentecost fire yet? Oh Lord, man. You feel a Pentecost fire yet? You have sweat yet? And me alone, I sweat, me realize, you know. So I'm going to follow somebody and raise a little higher woman say, lift Jesus higher, a little higher, from the third to eternity. If I be lifted up from this earth, I will draw all men unto me. Lift Jesus higher, a little higher, from this earth to eternity. He said, if I be lifted up from this earth, I will draw all men. One more time, church. Come on now, lift Jesus higher, a little higher, from this earth to eternity. He said, if I be lifted up from this earth, I will draw all men unto me. Welcome, 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 blessed Holy Ghost. Oh. Shall we praise the Lord? Shall we praise the Lord? Praise the Lord.
We have come into His house, gathered in His name, the Lord, worshiping Christ the Lord.
So forget about yourselves.
us give Jesus a big round of applause this morning. Let me give the Holy Spirit a bigger round of applause this morning on this, our Pentecost Sunday. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. You may be seated. Today's reading on this Pentecost Sunday shows us two new things. In the first reading, the Spirit makes the disciples new people. And in the gospel, he creates the disciples and he gives them a new heart. You see, the Feast of Pentecost is not really long time ago. The Jews celebrated Pentecost as a reception of the law from Mount Sinai. And it was the time that they finally understood the law. It's the time then that they felt like, before even they knew the Holy Spirit, that finally the Ten Commandments made sense. It's a time when they realized that, hey, we all are divided, the whole 12 tribe of Israel, but these commandments are saying something to us that is bringing us into harmony. You see, the law that they received focused on personal and collective well-being. Everything about Jesus all the time is not about me, myself, and I, but it's a collective thing. Everybody included. And so the worship of idols, the making of idols, the pursuit of wealth and power and dominance and glory were always manipulating the people's mind, was always getting into the way. Their worship wasn't true because their lives were contrary to the commandments. And so in this pursuit of wealth, power, and fame, corruption, they started robbing and fighting against each other. And such a theft resulted in a nation becoming vulnerable to other nations. My dear friends, the Sinai that was built then is that new Sinai that is being established among us. The Mount Sinai that the tablet was on with the commandments is that new Mount Sinai right here with us today. And it's a Mount Sinai that is saying to us, and this mountain of God is a way to peace. A peace that would lead to prosperity. A peace that would lead to peace for the nation. This peace was called Shalom, which meant that conflict would exist, but God's peace would be with us. The peace was hope for the nation, that all would share in the prosperity and the peace of Jerusalem. It signifies God's justice. And God's justice is simply that all creation has what it needs to flourish. The Holy Spirit is that peace that comes upon us and gives us everything that makes not me, not you, all of us flourish. The peace within our hearts and minds is for each and every one of us. It's for our nation. It's for our people together. And so Pentecost that we celebrate today as a peace was the time when the apostles and the disciples came to that new Mount Sinai. This was not the Mount Sinai that Moses was upon when smoke and fire and earthquake and storm. This came from a wind and a tongue of fire resting on the heads of those followers of Jesus. The fire that was on Mount Sinai is the fire that comes down and rests into the hearts of the disciples. The fire that we feel when we come to church on a Pentecost Sunday like this is a fire that kindles a passion in our hearts to tell about the story of God. It's a passion that kindles in our heart to go out and be on ministry. It's a fire that comes in our heart to say, I am going to blaze the trail like Jesus did. Come what may. It's a fire that says to me that I want to be on the rising with Jesus. I want to be lifted up from this earth as Jesus. I want to see the Father face to face as Jesus. You know, there's a song that says, there is a fire blowing. You ever hear that before? It said, there is a fire blowing, blowing through the trees. There's a fire blowing this morning, my dear friends. It's a new fire that is blowing. And this fire is what we heard in the gospel. The breath of God is being breathed upon us. You hear what I say? The breath of God is being breathed upon us. That same breath of God is the breath of God that gave life. What happened when God formed man? He breathed into him and he gave him life. And perhaps we'd better say that he got spirit. When God breathed on Adam in the beginning, he got spirit. And that spirit animates humanity. The story of creation that we all know, the story of humankind, is the same story that we hear today. God made them in the image and likeness, male and female created. And something about humanity experienced a difference from animals, a difference from the rocks, a difference from the plants, the fish, the birds, and everything. There's something about God that animates us. And that's why I don't mean to say it in any way, but if we're not animated by God, then what is animating us? If we become passionate about what we see on CNN, but when we talk about God, we say it under our breath, what is animating us? If we're passionate about gossip and sus and PMP and JLP and who gonna win the next election, if Nigeria do the country right, of, and we can spend hours talking over rum about these things, but when we're supposed to talk about God, it's a 5-minute conversation. Do we really have the spirit to animate us? A gospel passage gives us a beautiful description of the gift of the Spirit. Jesus, on the night, on the first day of the week, he goes amongst them. And the tragedy of the cross is still fresh with them. 50 days later, and they're still suffering that their Savior is no longer with them. And so he goes in their midst and he gives them what? Peace. He says it to them, peace be with you. It's not a peace that is an absence of conflict, but a condition of flourishing. It's a condition of human beings and all created things receiving peace. And they're wondering to themselves, yeah, we know it's you, Jesus. You've been popping up all over. But what kind of peace are you talking about? We're locked away up in a room because we're fearful of what might happen to us. And so he looks at them a second time and he says it to them very clearly, peace be with you. And so he says to them, peace be with you. And this time he gives them that life that I speak about. He gives them that life by he says to them, receive the Holy Spirit. Jesus isn't about talk alone, you know. It's about action. And he gives us that same example. He breathes on them and he says, receive the Holy Spirit. And the gift of the Spirit is something that is as essential as the breath of life. The second time that Jesus breathes on them, he gives them the Spirit. And the first one was from the cross when he gave up his Spirit. And now he said, it is finished. He handed over his Spirit. And that Spirit was with his mother, with his church. Today, the risen Lord is breathing upon us. And he's saying to each and every one of us, receive the Spirit. What is the Spirit that I'm talking about? What is the Spirit that will come here today to celebrate? Is the Spirit something we can see? Or is it something that we can feel? The Spirit that I'm talking about is that after 50 days, Jesus breathed on the disciples. He says, receive the Spirit. And after that, he says, go out. I've established a covenant with you. I've made you my own. Go out. So do we have any responsibility more than just coming to church? Is our Christian life, that Spirit-filled life, the Holy Spirit breathed on every one of us, just coming to church on a Sunday? If so be the case, don't bother come. The Spirit on us is more than just Sunday, my dear friends. The Spirit breathed on us is giving us a responsibility to remind ourselves we're no longer slaves. We're no longer in bondage. We're no longer people hiding. We're no longer locked in an upper room to say we're going to worship Jesus in spirit and in quiet. I want to have a talking sense this morning. There's a spirit that God has given each and every one of us today to say, guess what? Get up, get going, and tell the world about me. It's not a spirit for us to just keep to ourselves, that every time something comes in our life that is troublesome, that is when we call on the Spirit. It's not a spirit that's to say, it's only when we come to church, we experience the Spirit, and we raise our hand and praise God. It's not a spirit to say, only my 5 minutes of devotion in the morning is when I invite the Holy Spirit. It's through the day that the Spirit comes. My dear friends, this Pentecost and all the Pentecost that we have celebrated is a time for us to do this. Welcome the Holy Spirit. In every aspect of our lives, we should welcome the Holy Spirit. And I'm going to show something in it this morning. If you're doing something and you can't say at the beginning, welcome Holy Spirit, tap do it. I want to ever preach to a Jamaican congregation. Ever say, if there's something you're doing in your life and every time you're going to do it, you can't say, welcome Holy Spirit, we are here with you, you are with me, tap do it. Because our life is a spiritual life. And we have been given 7 gifts of the Holy Spirit, not to keep to ourselves, but to apply them to everything. We have been given these 7 gifts, wisdom, knowledge, faith, healing, miracles, prophecy, discerning of spirit, speaking in tongues, and interpretation of tongues. And why I'm going to make sure I'm going to say speaking in tongues, you know. You know, as Catholics, we say, when people start talking tongues, we say, watch them Pentecostal come here. Hello? And God give you that, you know. So if you ever see nobody skin up, no fear, see now when spirits start drop this morning or any time, they're going to go back home. Rice and peace is better for you than Jesus and speaking in tongues. My dear friends, the Holy Spirit comes and He gives us all of these gifts to use. And each of every one of us have received one of these gifts. Not everybody is going to come and say, I know what you're saying. This morning, we heard the readings in all these different languages. How much people can tell me the first reading? Lie. French. What them say? You don't know. I would say that. Thank you, Miss Joyce. Miss Joyce, I mean, I know. What am I saying on the second reading? Spanish. And what Tiffany say? Something. And Brother Patrick, boy. And one time I think you cause bothered up there, you know. It was it. Okay, so that's Swahili, the national language of Kenya. And so the Spirit is going to come. And all of us are going to have difference. The second reading says there are different kinds of spirit, but they are all given to believers in the same Spirit. There are different ways to serve, but they are all coming from the Lord. There are different ways the Spirit works, but the same God is working in all these ways and in all these people. My dear friends, all of us have gifts. All of us bring something to the table. And so the devil don't like to see that. Don't like to see unity. He don't like to see we're nice and happy and everybody joyful. The devil likes to seek diversity without unity in our church and in our world. And this happens when people we want to love become separate from us. When we take sides or form parties. When we adopt to rigid and airtight positions. When we become locked into our own ideas and ways of doing things, and perhaps even thinking that we're better than others, or always right. And when this happens, we choose the part of being separated from the whole, belonging to this or that group, belonging to this or that group in the church. And when we become avid supporters of one side, instead of brothers and sisters in the Spirit, you know what we become? We become like political parties. We become Christians of the right side or the left side. We become Christian of the green or of the orange. We become Christians, I would say in America, Democratic or Republican. And let me tell you something. It's one Spirit, you know. It's not two. It's not three. It's one Spirit in the church. My dear friends, the results of diversity without unity is when we're separated. And the opposite temptation is that of seeking unity without diversity. All of us this morning bring our own gifts. And that is why I stress the difference of the liturgy. Different languages, men dancing, choir with young, Eggie about 85, and the youngest one is about 7. Diversity. All of us bring different gifts. And as we bring these different gifts, it's for the building up of the kingdom. All of us have a part to play in building the kingdom. All of us who are baptized, all of us who believe in God, have received the gifts of the Holy Spirit. We need to ask the Holy Spirit, therefore, to breathe on our church. Whenever we see anything going wrong in the church, before we join in it, ask the Holy Spirit to breathe on our church. When we see anything going wrong in our family, before we take up the phone and call the other side, ask the Holy Spirit to breathe on our family. Whenever you're in schools and you see a child come home, I'm here at one of the schools, so they find a child with a guard ring, breathe on the school. When your children come home and something doesn't seem right, they might act off, breathe the Holy Spirit. Whenever your home used to be happy and jolly, and you realize there's a breakdown in family life, breathe the Holy Spirit in your home. My dear friends, when we look at our country, we need to breathe the Holy Spirit. The gift of that breath of the Holy Spirit is a crucial gift. Because when we read the apocalypse and we say all of these things, I feel like it happened now. You hear what I'm saying? When we read the apocalypse, Revelation, and it's so scary, it feels as if it is happening now. And the apocalypse, Revelation, mean end time. And so these end times that we're living in, these catastrophes that are happening, are very real. But guess what? As they are real, so is God. As they are real, so is the Spirit. As they are real, so is the Spirit ready to breathe on us. And so, my dear friends, the Holy Spirit is that fire of love burning in the church and burning in our hearts. And even when we thought that we could cover the Holy Spirit, or even when we think that our sins are so much that the Holy Spirit can't come in, it's really for us to stop and realize the Spirit is moving in marvelous ways. The Spirit is moving beyond our mere understanding. It's a time for us, therefore, to just stop and say a simple prayer. Spirit of God, Lord, who dwell in my heart and in the heart of the church, guide and shape my diversity. Like water, we need you to live. Come down upon us anew and teach us unity. Renew our hearts and teach us to love as you love. To forgive as you forgive. Come, Holy Spirit, and breathe life into our church. Come, Holy Spirit, and breathe life into our hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, and breathe newness on our world.
Breathe on me, breath of God. Thank you.
Lord, send us your spirit. That the Holy Father, Pope Francis, Archbishop Ken, and all our bishops, priests, deacons, and religious may inspire us all to a more fervent devotion to Christ, we pray to the Lord. Lord, send us your spirit. For all of us gathered here, that we may encounter Christ in our Eucharistic assembly, in our families, and in our communities, and in those who request our assistance. We pray to the Lord. Lord, send us your spirit. That the leaders of the world may realize that they must give an account of their work to Jesus Christ when he returns as our judge. We pray to the Lord. Lord, send us your spirit. That no one will be so attached to this earth as to regret being called into eternal life. We pray to the Lord. Lord, send us your spirit. For the Christian community, that through our celebration of the Paschal mystery and the Easter season, we may be renewed in spirit to live for Christ each day and place our talents and our energies in the service of Christ and his reign. We pray to the Lord. Lord, send us your spirit. For our church community and our families, that we will remain healthy and free from COVID-19, and that there will be an end to this pandemic. We pray to the Lord. Lord, send us your spirit. For all our youths, that God will guide their path, will help them to recognize the blessings which they have received and inspire them with new solutions for the challenges of our society. We pray to the Lord. Lord, send us your spirit. For an increase in vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, and consecrated life, we pray to the Lord. Lord, send us your spirit. For the sick and the suffering, and for those in our community who have asked us to pray for them, We pray that God's love and our care may bring them healing and strength. We pray to the Lord. Lord, send us your Spirit. Let us pause now and offer our own intentions in the silence of our hearts. For all our intentions, we pray to the Lord. Lord, send us your Spirit. That all our dead may ascend to glory with Christ, our priest and king, we pray now especially for those loved ones as we call them by name in the silence of our hearts. And so for all our departed, we pray to the Lord. Lord, send us your Spirit. Together, let us pray the prayer for families and vocations. God, our Father, in baptism you called me by name and made me a member of your people, the church. I praise you for your goodness. I thank you for your gifts. Father, bless your church with love. Raise up in Jamaica good and holy families, loving husbands, wives, devoted parents, and children. Raise up from our families and friends, dedicated and generous leaders, who will serve as sisters, priests, brothers, deacons, and lay ministers. Send your Spirit to guide and strengthen me, that I may serve your people, following the example of your Son, Jesus Christ, in whose name I offer this prayer.
God, our Father,
in
heaven, your Son is now seated at your right hand, throne in glory, leading us in your Spirit, that we may be your word and your presence in the world today. For you are our living word now and forever. Just this.
Thank you.
Advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope and Kenneth our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom we have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Yes, I believe, I agree to so. Amen, amen, let the world know. Yes, I believe, I agree.
Yes, I believe.
Amen, amen, amen. Yes, I believe, I agree.
Yes, I believe.
To so.
Yes,
amen, amen, let the word
amen.
Command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy kingdom,
thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For we need that the power and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. On that too. Friends, behold the Lamb of God. Behold Jesus, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. At this moment, we'll pray the act of spiritual communion for those who are unable to be with us at this time. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot receive you at this moment sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Today, for distribution of communion, there will be three stations, two at the center and one to my left. And so the persons on the left and the overflow at the back can come, and those persons on the outside can utilize the station on the left. Thank you.
our communion hymn. Hymn number 311. One bread, one body. our Thanksgiving hymn, hymn number 425. There's a sweet, sweet spirit in this place.
There are sweet experiences.
were filled with the Holy Spirit and spoke of the marvels of God. Hallelujah. Let us pray. O God, who bestow heavenly gifts upon your church, safeguard, we pray, the grace you have given, that the gift of the Holy Spirit poured upon her may retain all its force, and that this spiritual food may gain her abundance of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. Have some small announcements. Short.
Good afternoon, sisters and brothers. Without a doubt, we know that we have been revived when we shall leave this place. Happy birthday, church. Happy birthday, church. All right, welcome, Holy Spirit. Your announcements for today, Sunday, June 5th, and the week ahead. Yes, it is morning. Thank you for that. Weekday communion services will be held on Tuesday at 2:30 p.m. and on Thursday at 4:30 p.m. The Legion of Mary will meet on Wednesday at 4:30 p.m. The Archbishop's Development Campaign will be on and is on in earnest. This is for St. Jude's, despite all of our financial hardships last year, in the midst of the pandemic, the Archbishop's Development Campaign collected $6,211,583. The largest amount of funds we've ever collected since the time the Archbishop has been in the office. Give ourselves a big round of applause. Now, St. Jude's, your parish contributed 34.20% of that target. So a big, big hand to you. 32% of that Holy Per Millions was done by St. Jude's. And you are being thanked for your generosity. And this year, your parish target is just a change, $150,000 towards this campaign. And the Archbishop's Development Campaign will end on Stewardship Sunday, October 2nd, 2022. So it means then you have between now and October to collect $150,000. And that is very doable, right? Because you're in good stead. St. Pius X, same message to you. Despite the hardships of the last year and in the midst of a pandemic, we know that the Archbishop's Development Campaign collected over $6 million. And this time, I don't understand the math, but it says... Oh, sorry. Let me read that right again. You see, these numbers can trick you. Your parish, St. Jude's, you collected 34% of your target, of your set target. So this year, you're being asked to rake in $150,000. St. Pius, you contributed 91% of your target. Oh, not so bad. Right, very good. So this year now, St. Pius, you're being asked to raise the bar. Guess what your target is? No, man, $150,000, and we can do that. So $150,000 per parish. Father Mario, you're running some wealthy parishes, I suppose, but we will do it. We will give because God has been good to us. So no matter how we take it, on both sides of the fence, St. Jude's, your target is $150,000. St. Pius, your target is $150,000. And the campaign ends on October 2nd, and it starts as of now. So think about what it is that you will give. Your gift goes towards the activities of the Archdiocese and helps quite a bit with welfare and scholarship and other needs right across the Archdiocese of Kingston. So give generously. Father Mario will be out of office for all of this week, starting Monday, June 6th, as he'll be away on clergy retreat. So we're being reminded to keep him in our prayers, and we're also being prompted to give him a break during this week as he focuses on his clergy retreat. Every blessings, Father, as you engage in retreat, and I know as we are praying for you, you will keep us in your prayers too. Sisters and brothers, you're reminded to check the notice board for the additional announcements and other reminders. This is our usual reminder that we're still in a pandemic. COVID-19 is still here. So you're being reminded to continue to wash your hands regularly with soap and water and to teach your children how to do the same. Use your hand sanitizer with an alcohol content of 60% or greater when you're not able to wash your hands. Try not to touch your face as much as you usually do. Wear your mask, especially once you're out in public. Cover your nose and mouth if you cough or sneeze. Wipe down surface areas with sanitizing solutions, especially those high-touch areas. Practice your social distance when you're out in public. And continue to listen to your radio, television stations to keep yourself up to date with local and international happenings. Try not to listen to everyone who comes to you with a story that might seek to confuse you. And remember, we have the power of prayer. So let's continue to pray as we do our best to be safe. Is there anyone visiting with us for the very first time? Can you please stand? It's your first time coming to Mass here. Yes. Well, it's so good to see you. I'm just going to ask you to shout out your names from right where you're sitting or standing at this point in time. Can you say your name, please? Miss Marley. Arobin, okay. Thank you very much. And Gabrielle, you did well in French. Behind? Miss Hilda? Miss Hilda, right? Just shout out your names. Imani. Antonio. All right, got that right. Well, welcome, welcome, welcome to all of you. And if you have no church parish, we worship here at St. Pius at 10:30 on a Sunday. And I know at St. Jude's, worship starts at 8. So you can join either of the church families for the celebration of Mass. And we want to tell you welcome in words and in song.
Oh, we love you with the love of the Lord. Yes, we love you with the love of the Lord. For we see in you the glory of the Lord. And we love you with the love of the Lord.
Is there anyone celebrating a birthday today or during the course of this week? Please come forward for a blessing. Wow, the Pentecost babies.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to all of you, happy birthday.
Where the man go? Happy birthday to him. I'm thinking my father back here, you know. Okay, just checking. So we have what Stephanie just called some Pentecost babies. So, Joan. Joan and Joan and Terry and Kyle is celebrating their birthday today. So we give them a big round of applause for celebrating their birthday today with us. And then Sergio's birthday is next.
Sunday. But he's not come to church because I'm going to North Coast himself. So he make sure I come from today for him blessing. And then Sister Marie's birthday is Tuesday. Tomorrow, I'm is Wednesday. So when you did get into the get to know, you tell her, say, God made it, you know, so perfect that you're born 2 days before my baby, so we should be joining them. And them lines that we used to use in the past. Let us pray for our sisters and brothers. Brothers as they celebrate their birthday. Good and gracious God, we thank you for the gift of life. We thank you for these, your sons and daughters, our brothers and sisters who will celebrate one more year of birth. We thank you for the gifts that they are to the different church communities. I will ask, O Lord, that as they celebrate their birthday, you may give them all the gifts of the Holy Spirit. But more so, Lord, you may give them your love and give them your peace. And Lord, as they grow, let them grow in your wisdom, your knowledge, and understanding. I will ask all of this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Happy birthday.
Is there anyone traveling today or during the course of this week? Come for a blessing. Travelers? Any anniversaries? Wedding anniversaries? No? Okay. Let us remember to keep our sisters and brothers. Anniversary. Oh, wow. Come forward. Oh, they're so lovely.
Bind them together in cords that cannot be broken. Bind them together, Lord. Bind them together, Lord. Bind them together with the
loving God. Thank you for your Son who you sent to us, who showed us the deep, the true meaning of love. As these, your son and daughter who have come to become one and celebrate 31 years of wedding anniversary, we ask the Lord that they may be a symbol of love to our community. There may be a sign of hope that you are always present with us. In whatever vocation we take, we ask the Lord that as they grow, they may grow deeper together, more intimate, more in your love. And as they grow, Lord, they may grow in your grace. We ask you to bless them, bless their family, bless their children. We ask all of this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Bind them together, Lord,
and the Holy Spirit. The crook, the stem are divine. My car not. So turn and face each other. And I know when you sleep at night, you don't sleep in mask. So we can take it off, not true? Yes. And look in each other's eye, man. Don't look at me. It's not me, you love. Glendon, take off your mask. Your mask, yes. Put on mouth. Then. Look in her eyes, and is she as beautiful as she was 31 years ago? Sure. No, man, you have to say more than that, you know. You must say more beautiful. There you go. You'll get extra chicken tonight. Okay. You know, it's chicken, right? I forgot. And Pam, is he as handsome as he was 31 years ago? More great. Okay, so hold each other's hands. look in each other's eyes and repeat after me. I love you, Pam. I love you until the end of time. And I will always love you. And I will seal this love with a holy kiss. Okay.
Happy anniversary to both of you. Sisters and brothers, let us remember to keep in our prayers those who are sick and unable to attend Mass. Those of us who can call or visit, let us do that during the course of the week. But more than anything else, let us hold them in our prayers. God bless you, everybody, and welcome the Holy Spirit into your spaces this week.
Thank you. And just one additional announcement for St. Jude. So there will be a Sunday school for Sister Dahlia online at 5 p.m. So all the Sunday school children for Sister Dahlia, 5 p.m. online. I'd also like to just ask you to put your hands together for our choir that did so magnificent this morning. Also like you to put your hands together for the combined altar servers that we have this morning that showed serving at the altars. Also like to thank the persons who assisted in the decorations yesterday and today that sent up all of these flames and all of that, you know. And yeah, we have a nice, beautiful banner. And as you notice, you like it, Stephanie? Lovely. So I said to the person who make it, can we like what they call laminate or something? Just so you know, man, each year we're going to do a different one, bigger and better. So last year, you know, Sister, I did another one, this year and another. So next year again, we'll have a bigger and better. So thank you very much. You want to be named the person? Yeah, the person said no, but he spent a lot of time working on it, about 2 or 3 days. So thanks to all of them. And then thanks also to ensure that this Mass, for those who can't be here, they'll be here. So give a round of applause to the streamers as well. Come on. Yeah, and last but before the least, thanks to the persons who made the effort to do the foyer and seats all around. Please do not, I'm gonna sit around. Seats under the tree, Seats under the tree. And the food, me and meds, man, and that. So yeah, seats under the tree. So please do not rush home. It's a birthday celebration. So let's get to know St. Pius, the people of St. Jude, St. Jude, the people of St. Pius. And let's have a party. Cake and all kind of niceness is here. All right? Have a wonderful day and have a wonderful celebration. Oh, the grade fives that are doing pep. All right, all the grade fives that are doing their pre-pep, just run, come. Green pep. And as we're on primary school, raise your hands. So Rain is an athlete that I found out the other day, and I saw one of her races, and she did extremely well. I didn't know, I always wonder why you walk so weird, but no. Understand. And also, you know, future, what's the first, Shelly, and Elaine, and all of them. And then it's blessing, and make you always abound with the gifts of the same Spirit. And the church says, amen. May the wondrous flame that appeared above the disciples powerfully cleanse your hearts from every evil and pervade them with its purifying light. And the church says,
amen.
And may God, who has been pleased to unite many tongues in the profession of one faith, give you perseverance in that same faith, and by believing, may you journey from hope to clear vision. And the church says,
amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. And the church,
amen.
Thanks be to God. Next week, we return to normal time, St. Pius X, 10:30, and St. Jude's, 8 o'clock. Just to sing.